Lord of Contagion is an immensely powerful Chaos Space Marine sworn to the Plague God Nurgle, and in this video we're going to show you a fantastic method for painting this miniature that's really quick and easy and will have your army on the tabletop in no time, and in fact is really good for beginners as well. Now whilst we are going to be focusing on the Lord of Contagion, you can use the methods and colours that we show you in this video to paint all the Plague Marines in the Dark Imperium box set and the Photid Blight Drone as well. So without further ado, let's get to it. Whilst in this video we're going to be concentrating on painting just one miniature, if you're painting a whole Nurgle Plague Marine army, then what I recommend you do is paint it in batches. And by that I mean you select as many models as you want, say for example a whole squad of Plague Marines, and apply the first step to all of them, then move on to the second step and apply it to all of them, and so on. By this way you're creating a kind of production line, which you'll find to be the most efficient way of painting an army that there is. Now with your miniatures, what you need to do first of all is undercoat them and then paint them entirely with Death Guard Green. There is a spray version of this colour which does both those steps at the same time, which is exactly what we've done with our Lord of Contagion here. Now if you want to do it by hand, you can paint the Death Guard Green entirely that way, but be sure to undercoat the miniature first of all using Chaos Black Spray. But once your miniature is entirely green, we're ready to start adding some further base colours to it, and the first of these is going to be Lead Belcher for all the silver parts. Now be sure to give all your paints a good shake before you use each colour, and I'm going to be applying this mostly using a medium layer brush, but it's a good idea to have a small layer brush on hand because you will need it for some of the finer details. Now what you need to do is just get some of this paint and put it onto your palette in a little dollop like this, because doing so gives you more control over it and allows you to thin it down with a little bit of water. You don't need much, just a small amount mixed in there like that, just to thin it down a bit, perhaps a little bit more. And there we go, so you want about that sort of consistency before you start applying it to your miniature. If you do this, you'll find that you get a smoother result to it, so it's definitely worth doing. And what you're looking to pick out here is the axe blade, any chainmail, and any functioning metal parts as well. Now as you apply this colour, you may find some of that Death Guard green is still showing through, but that's not a problem. Just let the first coat of silver dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way, and you'll find this way you get a nice strong finish to it and it stays smooth as well. I've finished applying the Lead Belcher to all the parts I want to be silver, and with that done we're now ready to move on to the next colour, and this is going to be Balthazar Gold for all the brass parts. Now this is the more decorative metal, you're looking at things like trim and spikes, that sort of thing. If you want a bit of guidance for what bits exactly though, you can always check out the artwork on the back of the box, or in fact the books you get inside the box as well. Now I'm going to be applying this still using a medium layer and a small layer brush, and the technique is much the same as what we did with Lead Belcher. You once again use your palette to thin your paint down with some water, so you want it to be a bit smoother than that, I think. You're looking for about that sort of consistency before you start to apply it. And when you're ready, you just need to start picking these details out. So I'm going to start on this spike on the shoulder here, and as before, if you can still see some of that green through it, then just apply a second thin coat once the first one is dry. And there we are, the Balthazar Gold is now fully applied and we're ready to move on to the next colour. And in fact, we've got four more base colours we need to apply now, and the application for all four of these is exactly the same as what we've just done for the previous two base colours. So I'm going to run through those quickly for you now. We're going to be starting out with Screamer Pink, and this is for the cloak, but also all the tentacles and tongues on the Nurglings. And then we're going to move on to Zandri Dust, which is for all the bone and also all the guts, which I know sounds a bit weird, but don't worry, it'll all come together before the end. Then we need Mournfang Brown, and this is for all the leather, and finally Mechanicus Standard Grey for all the smoke. But we're going to be starting out with Screamer Pink, which I'm going to be once again applying using both a medium layer and a small layer brush. And as before, use your palette to thin your paint down so it's nice and smooth. And once you're ready, all you've got to do is start picking out these details. So I'm going to start in the cloak, which you'll see around here we've got some detail to be careful around now. We've got all this silver from the chainmail, and you can see I've been quite rough with it as I applied that. But as we put in the Screamer Pink, we can neaten up as we go. And again, you will need to apply two thin coats with this colour. The next base colour to apply is Zandri Dust, and this is for all the bone parts. So you're looking at horns and also teeth on the Nurglings, but also at this stage, be sure to paint all the guts as well. With that done, we're now ready to paint the haft of the axe using Mournfang Brown. And if you happen to catch any of the details whilst you're doing this, just neaten them up before you continue. And the final base colour to add is Mechanicus Standard Grey, and this is for all the smoke that's coming off the armour. Now that we've finished applying all our base colours, we're ready to bring them all together and give the miniature much more depth by applying a shade to it. And the shade we're going to use is Agrax Earth Shade. Now this I'm going to paint entirely over the miniature, and the ideal brush for doing this is a medium shade brush. And what you want to do is get a lot of this on your palette, get a good little puddle of it building up there like that, so you can control exactly how much you're applying at once. But for the initial stage, what you want to do is put on loads of it. And as you apply it, you'll see it just settles into all the recessed detail as you go along, really helping it all stand out. But because we're applying so much of this, you do need to give it plenty of time to dry once you've finished. About an hour will do the job, but as it's drying, just keep an eye on it because some of the shade will tend to settle too far towards the bottom of the miniature and build up into little pools down there. If that happens, just move away the excess paint with your brush. The shade's now completely dry, and you can see just what a massive difference it's made to the miniature, helping all that detail stand out nicely. And now ready for the next step, which is to use quite an unusual paint. It's called Blood for the Blood God, and this is going to do some really cool effects on all the guts and wounds. Now to use this, what you need to do is once again use your palette so you can control it, but you don't have to thin it down if you don't want to. If you want to keep it quite thick and gloopy, don't worry about adding any water to it. But all you do, using a medium layer brush, is paint this over all the wounds, the guts, all that sort of thing. And you'll see straight away the effect is really, really cool. So you can add as much of this as you like. Now our blood for the blood god is completely dry, the guts are looking disgusting, and we're ready to base our miniature. And for this, what you need is a Grelin Badland, which we're going to apply using one of these texture spreading tools because it's a texture paint. To use this, what you got to do is just get a scoop of it on the shovel side like this, and then on the base, just look for a more open area. So the front of the base is perfect for this. And what you do is just apply that scoop on there like that, then use the tool to start pushing it around the base, just being really careful around those nurglings just there. Switch to the narrow end if you just need a bit more control. Now once you apply this all over the base, give it about an hour to dry, and then all you need to do is paint the rim of the base. Now the colour you use for this is entirely up to you, but for this example I'm going to go for a Baden Black. And with the base fully painted, our Lord of Contagion is complete, ready to be unleashed upon the tabletop to lead the Death Guard into battle against the Ultramarines. So in this video we showed you a fantastic method of painting your Death Guard miniatures to have them on the tabletop in no time. And also, if you're new to the hobby, this is a really great method of painting your army as well, but there are a couple of things to remember. The first is that when you're applying your base colours, just be as neat as you can as you're filling them in. And then if you need to, apply two thin coats rather than one thick coat, because doing so will keep all those details nice and sharp, whereas one thick coat will tend to clog them up. Finally, when you're doing that all over shade, just remember to keep an eye on it as it dries to make sure it's not pooling towards the bottom of the miniature. If it's doing so, just move the excess paint away with your brush. So there you go, that's all there is to it. I really hope you guys have enjoyed this video, and we'll see you all again soon.